Republicans led by their leader, Donald Trump, have been preaching voter fraud, voter suppression, mail-in voting is a problem. All these different lies and falsehoods that they're pushing in order to subvert the election. So California Republicans are allegedly trying to prove this voter fraud is real by committing it a little bit of it themselves. So in doing so, they're placing fake ballot boxes in random drop-off locations around California, Southern California. The OC Register did an article about this. And the problem with dropping off ballot boxes all over the place for people to put their ballots in is that you're not supposed to. That's illegal. So there was a post from a Jordan Tai. He's a regional field director for the California Republican Party, and he was encouraging people to message him, send him a message to ask him for convenient locations to drop off their ballots. So he put up this post where he's masked, looking nice and responsible in front of an official ballot drop off box that they've stuck to this filing cabinet in someone's office with boxes in the background. And he said, doing my part in voting early, this is by far the most important congressional election I've ever voted in. I'm so proud to have cast my vote for Michelle Steele, DME for convenient locations, as I pointed out. So I'm not sure if they're only trying to appeal to Republicans, or if they're trying to get folks who maybe aren't gonna vote their way to just drop off the locations to get their ballots probably tossed in the garbage somewhere. So the OC Register went on to point out, reports came out Saturday night about a metal box that was in front of Freedom Way Baptist Church in Castaic that had a sign matching one on the Orange County box. The church posted on social media that the box was approved and brought by the GOP. And the post said the church officials don't have a key to the box and that the GOP officials pick up the ballots. And then do what with them is the next question. There was more things. Jerry Cook, the pastor of the church, tweeted open about it, and there was a picture right here. Our church has a voting drop box in front of our complex. If you're voting early, drop the ballots by. So one more point about this before I let you jump in, Emma. So they're not isolated incidents. These aren't just a couple of drop boxes they put in these two specific spots. Again, what the OC Register said, the California Secretary of State has received reports in recent days about possible unauthorized ballot drop boxes in Fresno, LA, and Orange counties. The agency spokesman Sam Mahood said this. These reports place such boxes at party offices, candidate headquarters, and other churches. So we know how illegal this can be, because we know how Republicans talk about ballot harvesting when people that want to help people to vote and maybe get their ballots to the right locations, pick them up for them because it's a trusted source, and then they give it and deliver that the ballots for them. And the complaints that come from Republicans all the time will say this, but when it comes to them creating their own, as usual when it comes to a complaint from a Republican group, is that don't do as what I'm complaining about. I mean, don't do those things Democrats that I'm complaining are doing. Do as I say, which is the exact same thing, but actually very illegal. So it mixes up fake news from real news and kind of gets people to come do their way. What are you thinking?
Well, it's always these like botched sting jobs by Republicans, and they're often projecting. So they want to do voter fraud. They want to subvert democracy. Donald Trump has been planting these landmines throughout the country, seeds, except they're going to explode on everybody, about election fraud and mail fraud. And he said, oh, there's all these ballots left in creeks. Yeah, every creek I go to just has ballots strewn around it. Just all of this sowing of misinformation, disinformation, discord, trying to get people to mistrust the process. And what's happening now is that his followers, other Republicans, are trying to speed up that process because it's not actually happening. So they have to set up the fraud themselves and do it themselves. It's always projection. They're the ones who want to do all of these illegal things, and they assume that everybody else is going to think to do these Machiavellian voter fraud, this Machiavellian voter fraud nonsense. I mean, there isn't enough motivation, people, to do voter fraud. It's not like you get $1 million.
Totally.
Right? No one's gonna do it because there's no payoff, except if you're some crazy ideologue like this Republican in California.
Yeah, the fact that, you know, this is what we already know. They say young voters and general, mostly disenfranchised voters from previous cycles have no interest in voting. They're always trying to get people to, you know, old 80s line, rock the vote. Maybe that was the 90s, I don't know, it was before I could vote. So it was rock the vote because they're trying to inspire young people to vote because young people don't like to vote. Young people generally vote Democratic. We know that's just historically how it goes. So if they're worried about people and Democrats specifically voting, wouldn't they just kind of fly by and say, yeah, they're not gonna vote anyway, it's all good? Instead, they're trying to suppress that vote even further because they do realize that voters are starting to come out more. It's a direct result of things changing. You know, it used to be rock the vote, now it's like, let's stop the vote, let's chill that out a little bit. So after this group got busted, you may wonder what their response was. They took to Twitter, didn't directly answer any media questions, but they took to Twitter and they said this, the California GOP. If a congregation or business or other group provides the option to do to its parishioners and associates or colleagues to drop off their ballot box in a safe location with people they trust, rather than handing it over to a stranger who knocks on their door, what's wrong with that? So this has now become a position where colleagues, parishioners, associates can drop off the ballot in a safe location. Based on who? Based on what? Hey, I'm J.R. Jackson. I'm gonna go to Office Depot, buy about 25 filing cabinets, drop them off in random locations around the neighborhood, slap a sticker on it and say, hey, you can trust me. Because honestly, you know what? If I was willing to do all that, you could trust me. I would take all your ballots and move it to where it needs to go. But what makes you think you can trust me? Why? Why would you trust me? What if I go to a bunch of Republicans and say, hey, Republicans, I preach against everything of all of your elected officials do every day. I can't stand them. I hate your president. Hey, but I got these drop off locations and I want you to put your ballots in those boxes because you can trust me. Because by the way, you could. So it's we're still along the same line of Donald Trumpian language where my only basis for convincing you of this is, come on, trust me. That's all they got. I don't understand how this keeps working.
Yeah, well, it's just like sheer force of will, I feel like, you know. No, I don't really have much to add to that. That was pretty perfect.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun, but you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.